We should just have two rows of people, or one entire row of people, leave for the next 2 minutes and then come back.
And we're gonna keep when you come back here. Right. Where I was 10 feet ago, or think about what I'm having.
my balance, watch my breath. Because as soon as I get distracted, my balance begins to slip, I begin to fall. Just like Matt did, I have to stay focused on the present moment. Another one that goes along with this is juggling. Now, meditation has helped me juggle in so many ways. For instance, if I throw in something in the air, there's a few different balls, different props, whatever it is, that I need to pay attention to in all different space and time. I need to pay attention to my hands, not just my hands, but my fingers, my wrists, and then my elbows. Gotta make sure, again, my shoulders are back and down. I'm standing with a strong posture as I'm juggling. So meditation helps, not just on the mat, but off the mat. In addition to that, mindful yoga has helped my snowboarding tenfold. Before I'd see a big jump, go, yeah, I'm gonna hit that, and then get up, get nervous, either just go to the top and fall off, or try to jump and it didn't go up. But now with my yoga practice, as I approach a jump, I'm thinking more of, all right, how's my body right now? How are my knees, my center of gravity? Am I leaning forwards, am I leaning back? So I think about each moment as I approach the jump. And then when I'm in the air, I'm no longer freaking out and panicking about, oh my God, I'm in the air, what's gonna happen? Instead, I can just enjoy that sweet hang time and just appreciate the moments in the air. And when I'm landing, I'd like to say I always land, but if you're not falling, you're not learning. So I could fall, I could fail, hurt myself, even though snow is soft, you'd be surprised if you go snowboarding. I don't focus, or I don't freak out over the pain of what's happening. Instead, I think about, okay, where is that pain coming from? Let me investigate it a little bit more. Let me make sure I'm still breathing. Let me not just panic at the bottom waiting for someone else to come to me. Let me investigate this pain, make space for it, make sure I'm okay, and I can get up and get to the bottom of the mountain. My mindfulness practice, by meditating, doing yoga and whatnot, for extended periods of time, overall has made me more attentive, more aware, and more focused for longer periods of time. Now this is great when I want to climb mountains, because it takes hours. Basically the same motion, basically just walking up and walking down. But doing this mindfully is important because I need to pay attention to my body, make sure my breath is okay, make sure that, you know, I'm breathing well, I'm hydrated, that the weather is cool, the weather is clear. And in the outside world, I need to pay attention to the small things like the rocks and the roots on the ground so I don't trip. I can't get sluggish, I can't just drag my feet. But I need to pay attention to the bigger scale too. Gotta make sure I'm following the right track up to the top or down to the bottom. So mindfulness has helped me in all these different ways. But there's more to that than what I do at home. My newest branch of mindfulness is how I meditate at work. I'll start with ping pong, because that's the funnest. The beginning of a ping pong game, you can imagine, is pretty light, pretty friendly. Passing the ball slowly back and forth with some light rallies. But 10, 20 serves later, suddenly the points are high, tensions are high, stress is high. I'm thinking, like, how did I let those last plays go the way they did? I hope the next ones are going to go my way. But as I'm thinking about what happened or what might happen in the future, I forget that I'm playing a game at this moment. So thanks to mindfulness and meditation, I can recognize that, you know, my head has become cloudy by all these different stressful thoughts, and I can just take a step back and breathe. Just let all that stress out for a moment. And then I'm back to the game, playing it as if it's the first one. But more than that, up here in the office, spending 40 plus hours a week here, commuting 5 plus hours a week, it's a lot of time. At first I was nervous. How am I going to spend this much time in an office sitting down? Thankfully, I learned to appreciate sitting. When I'm at my desk, it's easy to be on the computer staring at the screen all day long, trying to code and, you know, read that small font on court and whatnot. So it's important to remember to, let me straighten up. Let me roll my shoulders back and down. Let me sit up straight. Let me regain my composure and then go back to the work I'm doing. And importantly, I focus on just the work I'm doing at that moment. I try not to think about, all right, what am I having for lunch today? How long is it until I get home? What's that thing I was doing earlier? Do I have a meeting coming up? No. Just focus on what you're doing in that present moment. Be mindful about whatever it is you're in a meeting, if you're on call, etc. Makes the day go by much easier. So I'd like to wrap this up by leading you guys through a meditation. Because the thing about meditation is, as great as I can tell you about it, it's something you really have to experience for yourself. So if you feel uncomfortable, begin to just notice your breath as it comes in and as it goes out. Again, we've been breathing all day long, but barely pay attention to you. So maybe you'll notice that your chest is rising up and down, or you'll feel the air moving past your lips, up and down your nose. Feel the weight of your feet on the floor, maybe your butt on the chair. If you're standing up, make sure you're standing up straight. Now what I like to tell people at school when I'm back at home guiding meditations is to stand or sit with the properties of a mountain. A mountain is strong, stable, and proud to be where it is. At its root, it's solid. At the peak, it's lifted high. And if your body is a mountain, then your mind is the sky, and your thoughts are the weather. Now there could be all different kinds of weather, from big, puffy, beautiful clouds to dark, nasty rainstorms. But no matter what's happening with the weather, the sky remains. And all these clouds just pass through the mountain. The mountain remains where it is. It's important to practice mindfulness, to de-stress, to let go, and to just pay attention to what you're doing in the present moment. In this world of constant distractions and instant feedback, it's easy for our minds to get away from us. And your minds can quickly go from being your best friend to your worst enemy. So I think it's time we all start paying attention to